Hi, this is Dr. Nemechek. I want to talk to you this morning about autoimmune disorders and autonomic damage. All right, so the autonomic nervous system is divided in these two branches. We call them the sympathetic and parasympathetic side. And the parasympathetic branch is what flows down through the vagus nerve. The sympathetic side actually flows down through the spine and comes out. But so the parasympathetics are in the vagus nerve and is predominantly the controlling arm for inflammation in the body. All right, so like if you sprain your ankle, you need a little inflammation to fix the injury. Your immune system, your white blood cells, in essence, only will start becoming inflammatory if the parasympathetic branch of the nervous system gives them permission. And this is called the cholinergic anti-inflammatory pathway, or the vagal inflammatory pathway, or the vagal inflammatory reflex. But basically, the parasympathetic branch of the autonomic nervous system through the vagus nerve controls all inflammation. Think of it like a brake. The stronger the signal, less inflammation you have. You take your foot off the brake, it ramps up, you get more inflammation. That's basically how it works. Now, what we're understanding is it's looking like before you get an autoimmune disorder, the parasympathetic signaling via the vagus nerve has to break down. It fails. So essentially, you lose your braking mechanism, and you have to get this kind of extreme level of inflammatory dysregulation in order for autoimmune disorders to start. Now, they've shown this fairly conclusively with both rheumatoid arthritis and now Crohn's disease, and their different groups that I'm aware of are starting to march down other autoimmune disorders. And the experts in this field are highly suspect that we're going to find this throughout autoimmunity. That, so in other words, before you get Hashimoto's or rheumatoid arthritis or psoriasis or Crohn's or ulcerative colitis or MS or any of them, we are now suspecting you have to have autonomic damage first to the parasympathetics in particular, okay? How does that happen? How do you get that first and then you get the other things? Well, your autonomics, as I talk about in other videos, they can be damaged from physical injuries, emotional trauma, inflammatory stress from like vaccines and surgeries and fractures. And these are the ways the nervous system gets damaged. And now the bad thing is, you know, we're supposed to recover rather quickly from that. And if we, it's just that we have this other chronic inflammatory condition, kind of more of a low grade, if you want to compare it to autoimmune disorders per se, called inflammaging. It's the chronic release of pro-inflammatory cytokines that occur over time in your bloodstream. And these levels just rise, and cause all sorts of problems. And that is probably one of the major reasons why the autonomic nervous system is damaged. And these chronic inflammatory, cytokines from vegetable oils and saturated fats and bad gut bacteria and other kind of things, they create an environment that once you get a little boom kind of trauma to your nervous system, it can't recover, and now you're left with permanent damage. And that's what I refer to in other videos as cumulative brain injury. All right, so in order to get an autoimmune disorder, you have to have parasympathetic damage first. All right, and that's coming from chronic inflammatory disorder. So you got a ton of reason to control inflammation in your body if you don't want to get maybe some autoimmune disorder you're worried about because your parents have it or your sibling has it. And so a lot of high quality, high DHA concentration fish oil, a lot of high quality olive oil. We prefer California because it's monitored there. You got to get your gut in balance with the prebiotic fiber like inulin or the rifaximin, and just take good care of yourself. That's all for today. This is Dr. Nemechek of the Nemechek Protocol in Buckeye, Arizona. Take care.